Temperatures, though, warming quickly. We have a warm front crossing through. We can see where it's sitting right now. We're in the upper 60s in Roanoke, low 70s in Lynchburg. Still hanging out, though, in the upper 50s in Covington. That is going to surge further north throughout the course of the afternoon. That is going to take our temperatures back up into the 60s. But looming, look at this huge divide in temperatures. The biggest batch of cool air we've seen so far this season. It's in the low 40s in St. Louis, 30s in Denver, 30s in Montana as well. That is coming in this direction. It's going to modify a little bit, but getting into tomorrow, we're already going to see temperatures back into the 60s. By 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, we're starting things off in the mid-50s, pretty much where we did today. But instead of the upper 70s, we're going to top out in the upper 50s and lower 60s tomorrow. All because of this guy here, big-time cold front sliding through. That is acting as a pathway to send the moisture just towards our west. Thankfully, all of the heavier rain is staying away from us. We do have a few showers hanging out in the highlands right now, but for the most part, that's what it's just going to be, is a few showers. There's 4 o'clock, scattered showers, a few downpours, mainly staying to our west, getting towards dinner time tonight and really beyond dinner, 6, 7, 8 o'clock tonight. A few scattered showers possible, mainly along into the west of 81 overnight tonight. Try to get a stray shower or two in and across Southside, but for the most part, we are going to be on the dry side across Southside in central Virginia. Beyond that, we're going to start looking for the opportunity for our first frost of the season. This is going to come by Thursday and Friday. That's going to be another reinforcing push of some cooler air. On Thursday, mainly looking for that opportunity into the highlands. That's because big area of high pressure out towards the west. Our winds are still going to be elevated a little bit. Once we get into Friday morning, though, that area of high pressure parked itself right on top of Virginia. That's going to keep our skies clear. That is going to calm our winds, and that is also going to allow temperatures to sink down into the upper 30s. So frost is going to become a possibility once we get into Friday, especially. But then as we get into the weekend, look at this. Overnight lows are going to dip down into the middle 30s. So if we don't get it Thursday and Friday, don't worry. There's another shot for it as we get into Sunday and Monday of next week. Things have definitely changed across the board. We're right in ballpark, though, with our average, though. 11th through the 20th, that's when we see things start to turn and get our first frost across the Roanoke Valley. The 21st through Halloween across Southside. The 1st to the 10th, so a little behind for us across the New River Valley. And way behind as we get to the highlands. Temperatures this afternoon getting back into the 70s. We are in the low 60s tomorrow for highs. Just a stray shower or two passing by. They will be very, very light, though. Temperatures in the mid 60s on Wednesday, and then here comes our first round of cool air. Temperatures in the upper 50s. Overnight lows sink down into the upper 30s by Friday morning, Patrick.